Do you have time now?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay, here are citizens of Fukushima in this after the conference meeting, and they are asking you if you have any comment or question whatsoever you would like to say to them.
Right. Okay. I'll. Do I have to talk and then wait for you to translate this?
Yeah, I'm afraid so.
Okay. So one sentence at a time. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, my first thing that I want to say is that the citizens of Fukushima are living in an area which the Soviet Union would have considered to be an exclusion zone in terms of radioactivity.
Please go ahead, Doctor.
Yes. The levels of radioactivity which you are measuring with Geiger counters, which are, as I understand it, about 1 microsievert per hour, they convert into a contamination of the surface of the ground of levels which are close to the border of the Chernobyl exclusion zone, and which would be illegal under European law.
Doctor?
Okay. Well, although it is illegal under the European law and under the laws of the under the regulations or limits of the ICRP, the real problem is that these limits are already wrong, because for these kinds of exposure, the ICRP model is completely incorrect, and the ICRP themselves agree that their model is incorrect. The situation is that these internal radionuclide substances like plutonium, like strontium-90, like tritium, and a whole range of other substances, including uranium, which is very dangerous, existing in the form of particles, these substances carry an enormously high risk of causing ill health in your children and in parents and in pregnant women and in animals and in all creatures that live in this area which is contaminated. Now, the people there will already know that this is true because their children will be getting sick. The children will be getting sick. These sicknesses that you get are a result of inhaling and eating substances that are contaminated with hot particles of uranium and plutonium and other radioactive substances. Now, none of these substances can be detected with Geiger counters. So when you measure the 1 microsievert per hour, you do not include any of these substances in that 1 microsievert per hour. We know that these substances are there because I have in my laboratory and my colleagues have measured in other laboratories the contents of car air filters, the filters from vehicles, from lorries and from cars. We have analyzed these. When we open up a car air filter and we put the elements next to a piece of X-ray film and develop the film, we see little white dots all over the film, little white splashes of light. These are called hot particles, and they are very small. You cannot see them. They're almost like a gas. And if they're inside the car filters, because the car breathes air, this is the same as people breathing air. They will be inside the people, inside the lungs, inside the nose, inside the gut, and they will be causing significant harm. Now, Japanese scientists are just as clever as scientists like us or anywhere in the world, and so they would have done these experiments as well, but they have not told the people the answer. Well, the result of all of this is that the people who live in this area and who are ingesting and inhaling these substances have to take their children away from this area to a safe area as soon as possible. This is a very serious matter. In the last 20 years, an enormous amount of scientific evidence has emerged from people who were exposed to the Chernobyl radiation, which is very similar to the Fukushima radiation. And this evidence shows that the risk model that is being used now to define limits is totally wrong. And for some substances, it's in error by a factor of more than 1,000 times. I have acted as an expert witness in more than 20 court cases in which this issue has been raised, and these court cases have all been settled or won, because in front of an independent judge, the evidence is so strong that the case is always won. And I hope that I can help the citizens of Fukushima to enable them to make sure children are safe and removed to a safe place before they get sick. Okay, well, thank you very much for listening to me.
Thank you.
Thank you.